So I have two calipers or dividers. They're both the same. If I set them up, you can see the jump from here. We have the jump from this one to this. And that's the same on this set from here to here. And when I line them up, you see that the second division sort of grows at the same rate. So now I've got this one over here. That turns up there. And if you're following along carefully, you can now actually work out what the number is. But let's just stay with the dividers for a little bit. Now, if I sort of widen this out a little bit, that's lined up there. And then this middle one is now lined up with the gap of the first two. But this one is now lined up with these two. So I'm going to widen it a little bit further so that I get out this one. Now, this middle one is like that, and this last one is the full thing.
Are those two sets of calipers the same?
They are. So if I go back to, they are exactly the same. So we could try and do it with one pair, but it's hard to line something up against itself. So when I look at the different possible jumps from this one to here, from here to here, from here to these two, from these two to these two, and from these two to the full thing, it's the same ratio every time. Is that a specific ratio? Is it many things? Let's find out. So we sort of have from here to here, let's call that one. And then from here to here, that's going to be X. This is our mysterious number. And then from here to here, that's going to be X squared, because whatever proportion we took from here to here, the same proportion goes from there to there. Now, let's go from here to here. And that is going to be X cubed. If you recall, this leap here fitted on to this here. And now we've got something which is going to give us an equation. We can say that X cubed is equal to X plus 1. And this might be familiar to people who've seen the golden ratio, which is a very similar formula, but you've got an x squared here. If x plus 1 is x cubed, we can just multiply x and 1. So this is going to be x to the 4. And now we can look at what we've got. And here I've got my x squared, and here I've got my x cubed. When I combine them together, I have sort of x squared times x plus 1, and by this same equation we get x squared times x cubed, which is x to the 5. Across this whole thing we get x to the 5. And so this value of x, this polynomial has three solutions, but two of them are complex numbers, so they're clearly not what we want. But this is 1.325. And it is called the plastic ratio, which is a bit unfortunate as a name.
Why is it called that?
Well, it was named before plastic was named plastic. And it's the old meaning of plastic, meaning a sort of flexible or multi-purpose number. And one of the first people to investigate it, Hans de Lijn, who was actually an architect and a monk, I think he named it the plastic ratio because he thought this was the real ultimate system of beauty that you could use for architecture and all that stuff. And he even designed a building on the basis of it. And so he was really setting it up in opposition to the golden ratio. The real fact is that there isn't a single number which can express all beauty. But this number, the plastic ratio, has many interesting properties like the golden ratio. And so it is quite useful for architects to, you know, there's some nice ideas to use in design. So we've got these calipers, but maybe we can look at a couple of the other things. Thinking about the golden ratio, one of the things you can do is I can just take a square and then build another square, and then I can put a square onto them here, and then a square here, and a square here, and I have 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, your classic golden spiral. What would happen if instead of using squares here, we used equilateral triangles? I start with an equilateral triangle, put another one on there, and get another one on there. But now I've got a bigger one. It's going to go there. Bigger one again. Got one more over here. So now the side lengths are 1, 1, and 1. And then I get, this is going to be two. This is the same size, so that's two. This is two and one, so that's three. And this is three and one, so that's four. This one here is going to be four and one, so that's five. So we get, instead of the Fibonacci numbers, one, one, two, three, five, we get what are called the Padovan numbers, which are one, 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 two, two, three, four, five. The next one is going to be two and five, so that's seven. Then we're going to get seven and two, so that will be nine, similar to the Fibonacci, but you, instead of just taking the two previous ones, you skip one. So let's start with just one, one, one. Fibonacci would be one, one, I'd add these two, but I'm going to skip this and I'm going to add these two together. So I get two, that's the sum of these two. Now I'm going to skip that two and add the two ones, so that's two. Skip that and add these two, three, skip that and add these two, four, five, seven, nine, 12, 16. The effect of having the equilateral triangle is you get that skipping effect because you're going around three sides. You miss out the side you just put in, then you're connecting things up.
How does that tie into the plastic ratio?
It's a similar rule back to the golden ratio. How did we find that the Fibonacci numbers end up being the ratio between one and the next? Well, the way you look at it is I replace this drawing where everything is squares by one rectangle, like cut a square off, and if this is five and then one, so now I have a square, this is one and one, this is length one, and so this length is phi minus one, but because phi minus one is equal to one over phi, so this rectangle here is similar to the whole rectangle. As I build up my spiral, I get closer and closer to phi. With this, it's a slightly more complicated setup because I've got more sides there. But if I look at how the sides come together, and I can say if we started with one, instead of doing this addition, we said this was x, and then this is x squared. This term here is now going to be 1 plus x. So this is x cubed, but it's also 1 plus x. We again get x cubed is equal to 1 plus x, which is familiar from what we had for the plastic ratio. So I actually have a bit of a challenge for Numberphile viewers. There's something that I came up with. It's just such a simple thing that I can't believe it's not out there somewhere. And so find other references to this sort of idea. I guess we need to come up with a good Greek letter for the plastic ratio. Pi would be good, but that's sort of taken.
Yeah.
Psi for plastic. With the golden ratio, I cut off a square. In this case, instead of cutting off a whole square, I'm going to cut off a similar rectangle. So that gets me about here. Now I'm going to cut off a square, and I want this rectangle here to be the same as the whole thing. This is a similar rectangle, so if the long side is now one, this is going to be one over psi. Then this length is going to be psi minus one over psi. And we want this to be similar, so the length is going to be this thing divided by psi. So that's one minus one over psi squared. This is a square, so this length is also psi minus one over psi. So now I can add these two together and I get one. So I have 1 equals psi minus 1 over psi plus 1 minus 1 over psi squared. So now we've got 1 on both sides, so we can cancel those. And then we're going to multiply through by psi squared. 0. And this again gives us that same equation. So this box if we have the property that we take off a similar rectangle, we take off a square, and we're left with a similar rectangle, has this same proportion that we've been looking at again, we get the same equation coming out. You know, this idea of the golden ratio is one that's just such a classic. Anyone interested in mathematics and beauty will have at least seen that. But when you've got a very similar process, you take off a similar rectangle, a square, and you're left with a similar rectangle. I've found some small references, and occasionally people will draw up something, but there doesn't seem to be any systematic study of these sort of proportion systems and what you can play around with them.
The golden ratio is famous. People will say it's the most irrational number. What's the plastic ratio's claim to fame?
It turns up in some of the more exotic sort of stellations of polyhedra. It turns up in this wonderful spiral. But I think actually this divider is the real plastic ratio claim to fame. Because we had the property, if you notice, that I can choose any two of these pins. And the gap between them will be the power of one number. There is a version of this you can do with the golden ratio. But that only has three pins, not four. There's no way to do that with five pins. So if you want a set of dividers where the jump between any two pins is a power of the same number, then this is the best you can do.